Hi guys, good morning to all of you. This is Morning Tales for 9th August 2019. And today we are going to discuss the Monetary Policy Committee's new report which has come out, what they have decided through a lot of questions, and we'll also be picking up a lot of other questions related to the field of finance. So what I've done from today's Morning Tales is I'm going to focus more on banking and finance plus the static portion of general awareness. Of course, we'll be having some questions from other areas as well, but the primary focus is going to remain or be shifted to finance and banking. The idea is simple. Finance and banking is easy to understand but difficult to explain at times, and therefore I see that a lot of students are unable to understand or unable to find any place where they can understand it correctly. A lot of people out there are unfortunately explaining it incorrectly. And I wanted to remove that confusion among students, remove all that non-clarity among students, and that is why the shift in focus of Morning Tales towards finance. Okay, so let's start with the first question, which is an easy one. I'll be explaining to you what is the expected advantage out of this, partnership between these two companies. The question is, with which company has PMS Bazaar partnered to provide India's first all-in-one PMS and AIF tracking portal for investors? So two companies, PMS and eBix, have come together and created an online portal. The purpose of this portal for investors is to allow them or provide them the facility to seamlessly analyze their entire gamut of investments in a click. So with this, the investors which are there on this portal will be able to analyze their investments with a click. The basic idea is to improve upon financial technology so that investors are in a better position to analyze their investments with as little effort as required. Okay, so the answer is eBix Cash Financial Technologies. Let's coming to the MPC. What is the new GDP growth rate for 2019-20 projected by National Council for Applied Economic Research? A lot of organizations, including RBI, including CRISIL, then you have Asian Development Bank, IMF, all these have come up with the revised projections for India's GDP growth. So all of them are important. Let's discuss them one by one. First of all, what does the NCAER, National Council for Applied Economic Research, what is NCAER saying about the revised GDP growth rate for 2019-20? Okay, number one is that. So NCAER says that GDP growth for 2019-20 will be at 6.2%, down from 6.8% of projection that it gave before. So as per NCAER, 6.2%, it was 6.8% before. So this is before and this is after. Okay. Now, other than NCAER, which all organizations have also provided their forecast? RBI says something. RBI says 6.9%, down from 7%. It was 7% before, now it is 6.9%. That's why the financial markets, the stock markets have gone down. IMF, what is IMF saying? IMF is saying 7%. IMF is saying 7%. IMF and Asian Development Bank, both of them are saying now 7%. So IMF and Asian Development Bank. CRISIL, what is CRISIL saying? CRISIL is saying 6.9% now. We don't know what it was saying before, not available to us right now, but 6.9% now for CRISIL and 7% IMF and Asian Development Bank. Okay, so these are all the major forecast changes that have been given. Now, there is some forecast of inflation as well. Inflation projection for the second half is 3.5 to 3.7%. So inflation projection has actually increased. Inflation projection has increased. It was, let me remove all this. So inflation projection was 3.4 to 3.7% by RBI. Now the lower border or lower range has increased, 3.5 to 3.7%, which is good because we're coming close to the range, long-term range that we have, and I'll have a question on that as well, which is going to be a little confusing for you at the first moment. Okay, so these are all the major projections. So according to NCAER, the answer is 6.2%. What is the new GDP projection for financial year 20 by RBI? What did I say? What is RBI saying? 6.9%. It should be financial year 19, which because we are talking about 2019-2020. Okay. Okay. So the answer to this question is 6.9%. What is the new cap introduced by RBI on a bank's exposure to a single NBFC? Now this is very interesting question, because RBI has come out with certain changes regarding the exposures to NBFCs. It says that a bank's exposure to a single NBFC can be as high as 20% of its tier 1 capital. It used to be 15% before, now it has been increased to 20%. So 20% of tier 1 capital in a bank can be invested or can be given to NBFCs. That is the number one change. Okay. Secondly, it has also allowed that if, let's say, this is a bank, bank is lending to NBFCs, and this NBFC is lending to agriculture or small enterprises or housing. Agriculture, small enterprises or housing. Then it will come under priority sector lending. What is the limit? 10 lakh for agriculture, 20 lakh for micro and small enterprises, and 20 lakh for housing per borrower. Okay. So this will be classified under priority sector lending for the bank. So the banks are going to be encouraged to lend to NBFCs for on lending to all these three sectors only, so that they can fulfill their priority sector lending targets. So what is the new cap introduced by RBI on a bank's exposure to single NBFCs? The answer is 20%. How much is the medium term CPI inflation target set by RBI for 19-20? After the introduction of Monetary Policy Committee and Monetary Policy Framework, the medium term target of CPI is always 4% with a range of -2% and +2%, right? So the range is 2% to 6% overall range with the medium of or the middle number of 4% where the CPI inflation should lie. So the answer will always be for this question 4%. That is why this question is a little confusing. You might think that this has been changed and you might try to search for it, but it will not be available anywhere because the medium term target stays the same. What is the new repo rate? So the repo rate has also been changed according to new Monetary Policy Committee, reduced by 35 basis points. What is the new repo rate? 5.4%. What is the reverse repo rate? 25 basis points below 5.4%. So it is 5.15% now. Now, it used to be 100 basis points or 1% below the repo rate, but that is not the case anymore. The RBI decides reverse repo rate also independently. Marginal standing facility rate is 5.65%, remember that, and bank rate is also at 5.65%. So these four numbers are the ones that you always have to update yourselves with if you are preparing for banking or financial examinations. They are very important. So the answer to this question is 5.4%. Who among the following are the first awardees of Maiden Legacy of Americana Award 2019? So Maiden means first. So the first Americana Award, Legacy of Americana Award has been announced. You can have a liquid spotlight. All the names are available there. Two most important names, Rhiannon Giddens and Frank Johnson. Both of them are singers and both of them have been awarded in this Maiden Legacy of Americana Awards. Next question, who has been ranked at the top spot in Forbes list of the highest paid sports women? So Serena Williams has been given the top spot yet again. So consecutively, she has been at the Forbes list of highest sports women. And in fact, tennis players have been at number one for quite some time. So the answer is D, Serena Williams. Who is the chairman of Syndicate Bank? New chairman of Syndicate Bank has been appointed. Therefore, it becomes important. The answer is A, Ajay Vipin Narnavati. Where is Tungabhadra Dam located? A little confusing question. A lot of people think that it's in Andhra Pradesh, but the answer to this question is E, Karnataka. So it is not in Andhra Pradesh, it is in Karnataka. In fact, a homework for you, I have missed out on something provided in the Monetary Policy Committee. I want you guys to go through the Monetary Policy Committee once, the recommendations that have come up or the announcements that have been made. It's small page, probably two pages available on RBI website. Go through them, provide me the numbers that I have missed, the important ones, okay? So that you are able to identify what is important and what is not important. Give it to me in the comment section below. I will tell you which are the following numbers that you've provided or the facts that you've provided or the announcements that you've provided are actually important or not. So that will be a good home exercise for you guys that you can do in the entire day. Okay. You can also submit this quiz and you'll get the answers immediately. So you can take these quizzes and the past quizzes as well directly through the website only. Go to the quizzes section, daily current affairs, and you will be taken to these quizzes. Now there are a lot of other quizzes as well on RBI Grade B, SEBI, UPSC happening here simultaneously. So all of them can be taken by you. So these are, this is the entire, repository of quizzes that I have here, which are being updated on a regular basis. Okay, so that was all for today's lesson. If you did like it, do not forget to subscribe it. Do not forget to come back at 8 a.m. tomorrow morning. And in the evenings, I have some sessions on finance current affairs, which I believe are going to be very interesting and knowledge enhancing, as well as will help you prepare for the upcoming banking and financial examinations. All the very best. Take care.